further we will study about the precipitation. In precipitation, the number of rainy days plays a very important role in determining the vegetation of a place. With the same amount of rainfall, two areas with a considerable difference in the number of rainy days will have entirely different type of vegetation. Torrential rain on fewer days usually result in a great surface runoff and the plant get much less water. If the rain is moderate and occurs with uniformly on large number of days, the plant are highly benefited. In the latter case, even a small total precipitation is more effective. Small quantities of rain are of little or no use to the vegetation because evaporation is rapid and the water evaporates before it can sink into the soil. Scanty rainfall result in a poor growth of plant. The plant are stunted and bushy. Broadly speaking, three distinct kinds of vegetation, forest, grassland and desert, are developed as a result of rainfall. In the warm tropic, heavy rainfall distributed throughout the whole year result in an evergreen rainforest. Heavy rainfall but confined to a few months in a year result in a deciduous forest. In the region of high winter rainfall, sclerophyllous type of forest composed of low trees or shrub is developed. Grassland are found in the region of high summer rainfall and low winter rainfall. Desert are found in the region of very low summer and winter rainfall. The interaction of rainfall with temperature has a very profound effect on the vegetation of a place. Very heavy rainfall and high temperature in the equatorial and the tropical zone causes the formation of most highly developed vegetation of the world. The tropical rainforest of Southeast Asia, Africa and South America, if the precipitation is abundant, the temperature is low. Example, in the northern and the southern latitude, the vegetation consists of lichens, occasional small coniferous trees and scatteredly hardy shrubs and herbs. If the rainfall is low but the temperature is very high, the vegetation consists of a small scattered tree, shrubs and cacti of the desert. Moderate rainfall and a comparatively low and intense dry season result in a dry deciduous and thorn shrubs vegetation. Extreme low rainfall or complete absence of rainfall accompanied with high temperature result in a drought which often result in the outright killing of plant of the weaker type. Effect of precipitation. Rainfall affect plant by increasing the moisture content of the soil. The percentage of water entering the soil is more if the shower are gentle. Sharp shower result in a quick runoff. Continuous gentle shower percolate into the soil and reach deeper layer of the soil. The amount of water available to the plant as a soil moisture depend upon the rate and the kind of precipitation and also on the nature of vegetation. A proportion of water is intercepted by the branches and the leaves of the plant. A major portion of such water is evaporated. Light rain of short duration do not add to the soil moisture because of interception by the plant cover. If vegetation is spare, most of the rainfall reaches the ground, but in dense forest, they reaches the ground indirectly as a result of leaf drip and stem flow. The topography, the soil texture and the vegetation of a place are very important for the absorption and retention of rainwater. Rainwater is lost in the form of runoff on the hill slope and therefore the farmer practiced terrace cropping to conserve water. In the sandy soil of desert, the soil texture is loose and therefore water drains off. If there is a well-developed vegetation, rainwater is conserved and is allowed to percolate down in the soil. If the place is bare, water moves away rapidly, particularly if the soil particles are very compact. The rainwater which enters the soil is either absorbed by the plant or is evaporated into the atmosphere or percolate down as a permanent water table of the soil. The rest of the runoff water is in the form of drain, rivulet and river, etc., back into the ocean to complete the water. Thank you.